Fenyx saw the minions of Typhon had cornered the stranger, leaving no escape. This would be her greatest battle yet.
Oh, I hope the stranger dies.
If I had wanted to hurt you, I could just as easily come and stab you back there.
True that. So, I'm going to go.
Fenyx.
Unique name. Appreciate the assistance, Fenyx. Nice bracelets.
Thanks. I'm on my way to the Temple of Apollo to see the Oracle.
Me too. Ha! It's right over there.
Oh, great. I can use all the help I can get. We should go to... Hey, where did you go? My bracers! That rotten little thief! I saved you!
I know how you feel, kid. You do everything you can for them, and then they betray you. What's up with that? Who designed that entrance? A circus performer? A magician?
I don't know. Aren't mortals wonderful?
Step forward into the light. The mysteries I have to offer are as infinite as the grains of sand scattered across the floor. What is your question?
Oh, wise Oracle, how do I reverse the curse and turn everyone back from stone?
Wow, that's a real question. I don't know. It's a mystery.
Well, then, how do I get my stolen bracers back?
Ah, another mystery.
Yes, that's why I came to you, the Oracle.
Oh, yes. Well, circling that, I'm just the priest. The Oracle here turned to stone, but the smoke here is something else. Do you think sand? Is called sand because it's between the sea and the land?
Have you seen that little guy with golden hair? No? I'm going to go. funny?
You said the god twice, but you still haven't left.
My brother was turned to stone, and I can't save him. The one person I tried to help robbed me, and all you can do is laugh.
Whoa! Those are all true. Are you an oracle? Oh, on your way out, can you pick me up something? I'm starving!
Father of your line is not father of your kin. A mountain, crowned with flowing locks, is how you win. The monster shambles, hungry for immortal flaws. The true hero owns them all, stolen from the beast's jaws. With the winged herald's aid, go on the attack, and sooner than later, change them all back. A pearl of seas, forge fires lit, a wise child convinced, a feather's weight of wit. Eldest of Thetis, father overthrown, hero on high, it's time for you to come home.
Whoa. Now that was a prophecy.
What was? Isn't it weird how prophecy ends with I see? But in this case, I don't?
Stop! Thief!
You can have these bracelets back. You're going to need them where you're going. Come with me.
No!
Look, I'm sorry about stealing from you. It's just something I do. It's
kind of a problem. So, we good?
Not even remotely.
I needed an offering for the Oracle. I thought you were a nobody, and I didn't like your face. But that's all behind us now. We have to go.
Didn't like my...
We don't have much time. He will be here soon.
Who?
I have just a ticket for you to make it to the mainland. Where are those wings?
These?
Now who's the thief? Don't look so smug. They won't fly yet anyway. You have to find the other piece.
What do you mean, fly?
Focus. After that, we need a jar stolen from Aeolus.
It's in there?
I'll go begin the preparations. Meet me at the top of the observatory with the jar.
I don't understand.
You're in grave danger. Help me help you.
Okay, but about what you said earlier... And you're gone. Okay, well, gotta figure out how to get past that barrier.
The labyrinthine path before Fenyx seemed daunting, but the light of endless stars helped show the way.
Cargo goes to die.
What?
As Fenyx traveled through the underworld, her thoughts turned toward her mother and father. Were they safe in Argos? Had they too been transformed?
Fenyx
couldn't help
but... A huge monster appears! It's ginormous, but Fenyx just laughed.
So you want to dance, huh?
Oh, it's perfect!
The adorable monster was ever so playful. Everything she had prayed for to take her mind off her worries. It was a gift from Olympus she would treasure forever, deep within her vulnerable yet ever-expanding
heart. Fine, have it your way! Just don't make me vomit!
Fenyx faced the monster, ready. The monster attacked.
Oh.
time. We have so much to talk about.
Whoever, or whatever you are, you don't scare me!
Said this was Aeolus's jar.
I thought it would be a jar with the god of winds on it, not in it.
This little thing can't contain the wind. That's impossible.
As Fenyx continued her journey, she couldn't help but wonder if her story would one day be told amongst the stars.
Always says, the stars tell stories, but I don't get it. It's like I can't read.
Somehow that doesn't surprise me.
Looks like I'll need to solve this to get to the missing wing piece.
You can't solve the stars. The stars solve you. At least that's what a seer named Miss Clea once told me. And I won't tell you what happened after that. But those stars were bright.
She stole your money.
She did, yes. But I turned her into a juniper berry. So, overall, not a bad night.
named the Golden Isle, in remembrance of my greatest success and my greatest failure. May the gods accept my offering. May I see you again. Icarus.
These are the great Daedalus' wings! He must have built everything here too! All these temples! I can't imagine losing a son like that. What it does to you.
The wing piece recovered, and Aeolus's jar back from Tartaros. Now, to find that stranger at the top of the observatory.
What? I didn't kill Icarus! Daedalus's faulty wings did that!
And where is Daedalus now? I see. Silence.
I'm sure Fenyx will find out. Eventually.
You said you were preparing something.
Yeah, preparing for you to return. You got the wings?
Yes.
Not really good as new, but what is?
Something new?
You have the jar, right?
Get ready to open it.
What is that?
You deceitful thief! You thought you could escape me?
You stole something from that thing?
I told you, it's a problem!
Tweet, delivery boy! You do not deserve the crown you were given!
We'll take you down, Typhon! Just like before!
We? There is no we! Not anymore!
Fenyx! No! Open your wings!
I can't!
I have you now! You cannot hide forever!
Okay. We need to get to safety. Stat!
What was that monster?!
Typhon.
Not THE Typhon!
Oh, you have no idea. Gotta get to the Hall of the Gods, then we can talk. You ready to fly?
These were Daedalus' wings! THE Daedalus? The great inventor?
So?
So, they didn't work right and killed his son.
He'll be fine. Just don't fly too close to Helios. And also don't try to go to the bathroom during turbulence. You should make it to the mainland without crashing. Probably.
You literally robbed me, and now you're saving me. Why?
I didn't follow most of what the Oracle ran through. But if the prophecy is on the money, hero on high, you're the only one who can stop Typhon from remaking the world.
We don't even know if it's about me.
For someone trying to help everyone right and left, maybe you should accept help once in a while.
What are you talking about?
Fate's alive! How is the Winged Herald supposed to provide aid when you won't let me?
With the Winged Herald's aid? Wait, Winged Herald? No way! You are...
Hermes! I like telling half-truths, playing tricks, and taking long runs on the beach. Now, can we go, please? The other gods need our help,
other gods? You mean all the stories are real?
Something's wrong with your face. It's doing that slack-jawed thing again. Fly to the Golden Isle. Meet me at the Hall of the Gods. I'll be waiting.
And with that, Hermes disappeared. Fenyx gazed across the narrow band of sea at the peaks and valleys of the Golden Isle ahead. The long path to her true destiny lay stretched out before her.
Wait! That was just a prologue? How does it take someone that long to begin a story? Odysseus made it home faster.
She's about to jump. Be quiet and listen.
The Olympians think a pathetic army of scrubbers can stop me!
after I hear Typhon.
I may be only 1/1000 of a god, but I am 100% flaunting it.
I think we actually stand a chance.
Who's with me? No.
If things get ugly, know that will run.
The sight of the Great Hall took Fenyx's breath away.
This is incredible!
It's all right. Could use some updating. The column motif is a bit played out.
So, we're safe here.
Remember that thing I stole from Typhon? It was an itty-bitty piece of his eye, to hide this place from his terrifying gaze.
You're welcome.
You said this is the Hall of the Gods. Well, where are the others?
Let me start from the beginning.
With his hand on Fenyx's shoulder, Hermes recounted the tale of Typhon, destroyer of gods. Typhon, born of Gaia, was a terrible, cruel beast who vowed to free the Titans and obliterate the gods. He challenged Zeus for the rule of the cosmos. Fortunately, Typhon was defeated.
Damn straight he was!
And imprisoned under a mountain, where he could do no more harm.
I got to get back into that kind of shape again.
For thousands of years, Typhon festered, until Helios was eclipsed, and burning stars fell from the heavens. The stars burnt through Typhon's chain, and in an explosion of fire and smoke, Typhon burst from the mountain. The gods had wronged and tortured him.
Never again!
He vowed.
This world will be cleansed. The gods will pay!
And so, Typhon sought his revenge.
Destroy the veil that separates this hallowed land from the underworld. Let Tartarus walk among the gods! Trample, devour, and turn these life-false gods to dust! Come, Olympians! Brandish your weapons and face me! You have underestimated my power and wagged in your hubris!
bow to my unshakable perfection!
Some gods fled in fear. Others stayed to fight. Many were captured. Typhon split them apart, cleaving their essences from them, and transforming them irrevocably. In a final, desperate attempt to save their lands, the gods called on the heroes of old, the last warriors who had more than a few drops of god's blood remaining in their veins.
Weak and selfish! Your heroes will exist as shadows of their former selves, serving me forever!
The gods had failed, and so had the heroes. But just when all hope seemed lost...
So yeah, a lot of fighting and losing. And now you are our only remaining hope to restore these lands to their former glory and save the world from chaos. All we have, Fenyx, is you. No pressure.
I kind of lost track of who's who. Is that one with the spiky hair you or Typhon?
Forget it. The vanquished gods need to be reunited with their severed essences to regain their power. Then, together, you must defeat Typhon.
This is honestly a lot. I wish my brother was here.
Look, kid, I'm not perfect. I'm the guy who escorted Pandora to Earth for Zeus's sake.
But maybe, just maybe, you're the right hero at the right time.
Also, you're literally all we've got, seeing as how everyone else has been defeated. Good luck! I'll be right here, doing nothing. I mean, beginning preparations.
Thanks. I think.
Oh, there's that face again.
Fine. Your best starting point is to reach the top of the other statues on the Golden Isle, so you can track the missing gods. Find them, and they should be able to help you locate their stolen essences. Although, they haven't been themselves, so I'm really not sure.
What's that mean?
Guess you'll find out.
Fenyx, think. What would my brother do? Legiron would probably take on Typhon single-handedly, like when he bested the entire Spartan fleet. Who am I kidding? I'm in way over my...
Those are a few ideas for ways to stick it to Typhon. You mortals seem to need an incentive, so I'll pay you Electrum for accomplishing each. And since I'm the god of merchandise, you can spend it right here on, you guessed it, merchandise.
Ooh, creative.
Or you could always just pay me your own Electrum.
I thought the incentive was for me.
I'm the god of financial gain.
Those prices. Wow.
I'm also the god of thieves. We all have our vices.
What's that underneath?
It's a chore chart. Someone has to get Ares to clean up after himself. Ever tried to get blood out of a sea of blood? Now that is a feat. Let me know if you're in the market for anything.
Get their dental exams?
No, it's where we rip off our skin to change our appearance.
Huh. Still better than visiting the dentist. What's this?
Not sure. Hades had it delivered. Deposit an offering for the ferryman, and unexpected help could very well arrive. Be careful, though.
Argo broke the last gift from the underworld, and look what happened to him.
Who's Argo?
Exactly.
I'm here selling, if you're buying.
Nice cauldron!
Fenyx let the empty compliment die in the ensuing silence, and instead tried to focus on potential potion recipes.
You're cute. Try not to impale yourself on anything.
But Fenyx wasn't listening. She was drawn to the forge by a hidden force, the Aramantine she'd gathered, calling out to be reshaped.
There's that wonderful smell again.
Ambrosia is life. You want increased protection? Distill it here and drink up. Then enjoy the ride. One time, Athena downed that whole Kilix and destroyed the entire Greek fleet right after she had sided with them in battle. It was epic. Sorry. Guess you just had to be there.
Many of my relatives were. They died.
And I told Athena not to do that. But did she listen?
No.
Thank you.
I will make you perfect. You will suffer, but it will be worth it.
That's one soldier who's not getting up anytime soon.
Perhaps he was shipwrecked in the same storm that brought Fenyx here. Unfortunate.
At least he's in the right place for Hermes to guide his soul to the underworld, and hey, if he was still alive, he'd have been turned to stone by now anyway.
Fenyx will need to find some offerings for a proper burial.
Wait, what? Fenyx already has a job to do. For us! Stay on task, Fenyx.
coin, bearing Charon's mark.
Typhon stole those too? Charon was saving up for a bridge!
What hero will an hour yield? To gather ribbons, wine, and shield. These offerings will bring him rest. He fought his war. He gave his best. My time is short. The road calls me. Complete his tomb and set him free.
Someone carved all that into a board? Maybe if he hadn't spent all that time composing an ode, he could have buried his friend. So now Fenyx is going to supply ribbons, wine, and a shield? You didn't get heroes like this in the old days. They had focus.
The fastest route isn't always from Alpha to Beta, you know.
Hello there! At last, something we're paying attention to. Am I right?
Ugh.
Ribbons? You'll be pretty as a picture, kid. If I were a century younger, I'd transform myself into a swan just to woo you.
You remember, you already did that, right? That's how we got the twins? Or is it all just a blur to you?
Thank you.
The tale of Midas is a good lesson for mortals. Careful what you wish for. He could neither eat nor drink, because all he touched turned to gold.
Lucky gods don't have to eat. I would be rich!
And a good lesson for you would be... not everything is about Zeus.